next time, Carter. Man, I'll see you next time.
All right, man, I'll see you. I should be back in town. I actually don't know when I'm gonna be back in town.
Yeah, ayy, all this cash on me, I got a bag on me, yeah, money bags on me, all these racks on me, all this cash on me, got a bag on me, money bags on me.
So in short, I am moving and I'm excited. Alright guys, so before we get into this video, I need you guys to go ahead and subscribe, click that subscribe button, and I'm about to change my clothes. Okay, so, I've changed clothes, took a shower, things like that. So, I don't know what video we're about to do. Hold on, let me pull out my laptop. I guess I'll do this video. Alright guys, so the video we're checking out is XXXTENTACION, Look At Me. So Look At Me, that's like, you know, he made a music video out of a song. I know the song is old, but it's been called edgy. Everyone's saying, oh, he hanged somebody in the song. So let's check it out. Check it out. Okay, here we go. Okay, it's weird. I mean, we already know X is weird, but let's keep going. This dude is so weird, man. I mean, like, I like his music, though. I like his style. I mean, a lot of people don't, but his stuff is not that bad. It's all right. It grew on me, okay? At first, I wasn't that much of a fan, but it grew on me. It ain't that bad. Hey, you know, he said he put the blurry cam, you know. It's distorted. The video is set. The way he made it was to distract you. I like that. But let's see what he's got next. Oh man, he's got people hanged in this video. Like, it's black people hanged. Okay. Oh man. Mississippi, 1955. Oh man, I see what he's doing here. He's basically pointing out all, you know, the racist-driven crimes done in the past and by the law in our time period. So whoa, dude, he looks serious in this. He looks serious right now. I can preach peace, but say fuck it and preach the murder. Oh man. Let me guess, he's gonna decide that maybe the black kid has to decide, hey, I'm gonna hang the white kid. I don't know what he's gonna do. He put him, okay. Okay. Oh man. What is he doing? Oh man. Yo. Okay. So this is, all right, so I see why there's so much controversy. People are like, oh my gosh, how dare you, X? Why would you do something like this? This is terrible. Well, you know, I'm commentating over this, and I could say this, what he's doing is, he's symbolizing what white people did to black people back then, basically. He's, you know, white people used to sit in their chairs, sit back and watch black people get hanged, and this is what this is representing. Here you got black people sitting back watching a white kid get hanged. He's basically reversing, you know, what if we did this to you. So I see what he means by this, but a lot of people are gonna get mad anyway. You know, it's the internet. They're not gonna get it. They're gonna take it out of context like they do with PewDiePie. So yeah. Oh man, he is serious. You can see his face. Like, now a lot of people are gonna say, "Oh man, X, this incites violence from the black community. This is gonna make black people wanna go out and kill white people." I don't think so. I think what he's just doing is trying to show a message. I don't think. There's definitely two sides to every story, you know. Maybe he is trying to incite violence, but maybe he's saying, hey, we have a choice. We don't have to incite violence. There's two sides to everything. That's what I've learned in life. There's two sides. He can mean it both ways or mean it one or the other. But this is cool. Let's reverse that real quick.
They're skin. But to act out on these irrational thoughts in every shape or form is disgusting. You cannot, as black or white, call yourself the supreme race when moved out of your comfort by the opposition's color, their skin color. That is no.
He's right. Basically, what he's saying here is that from both sides, let's be honest, from black and white, let's be completely honest. Black people sometimes are afraid of white people. Sometimes white people are afraid of black people. Let's get that out the way. What he said was true. You can't call yourself supreme or better than somebody else if you are even stifled by the opposition's color. What he's saying is, if you're white and you're a supreme being, but you feel like you have to go and kill a black dude because you feel like he's dangerous, regardless if it's racial or not, to act on those thoughts and to think that you're supreme because of it is insane. So I see what he's saying here. He's saying, he's worded in a certain way that some people are going to take it the wrong way. Some people are going to be triggered by this. But let's keep going.
No form of being or demonstrating being a supreme being. If you are a supremacist, be unmoved by the opposition. Remain unscathed in the comfort of your own home and your own realm. Demonstrate care for the youth's future. White or black, black or white. Are you willing to risk your child's future due to your own bigotry? The choice is yours. But your child will not stand for the hate. This generation will be loved, nurtured, heard, and understood.
Damn, that was real. All right, guys, I hope you guys enjoyed that video. Yo, he basically just, he killed it, man. I gotta give it to him. X killed it, bro. He killed it. He did good with that one. Gotta give it to him. So if you guys want to see more hip-hop reviews, commentary, reactions, whatever that is, make sure you subscribe now. I gotta finish moving and stuff. Thanks for watching and peace. Hey guys, make sure you purchase the Merchwise Hot Boy and make sure you click the link in the description, man. What are you waiting for? Make sure you turn on post notifications, subscribe, and check out the latest videos in my music and the merch link and other stuff. I will see you guys tomorrow. Thanks for the support.